We're going to have a quick fly through into the subsurface of Glasgow. We're now focusing in there. The blue outline there is the Clyde catchment, and the dark grey areas here is the city of Glasgow. These are major redevelopment areas, picked out in orange. City of Glasgow boundary in black. And as we zoom in, and this is using geovisionary, an absolutely fabulous tool to visualise this sort of material, we see the Clyde Gateway development area in outline, mine shafts, and I'm going to focus just on five of those picked out in red. And there they are within that area of grey, extensive coal-bearing strata. So let's fly beneath the surface. Everything up to now, essentially Google Earth could have done for us. But now, we're entering into an environment that geovisionary comes into its own. We capture the tunnels and the rock layers and the mine seams, and this is just a few of the layers that we've actually modelled. You can see a beautiful dish-shaped structure. There's a degree of vertical exaggeration here, just to make it more obvious. As we fly around and look again along this synclinal dish-shaped structure, we can add faults to the model. They'll be picked out in red. There they are. These are just two of 73 that we've modelled within this small block here. Returning out of the surface and dropping down close to one of these mine shafts again. And what this will do is indicate to us where we could actually drill into the system. Because there are these areas surrounding the shafts where the tunnels are still likely to be preserved, and these would be the drilling targets, we believe. They're most likely to be preserved and in place. They would not have collapsed to any significant degree. So if you're interested in gaining access to the groundwater, those would be the points that you would probably target. As we zoom out, we see that the Clyde Gateway area is only a relatively small area in relation to the Glasgow conurbation. Nearly there. And there's all of the mine shafts of the Glasgow conurbation and just the distribution of one worked seam. So much, if not most, of the eastern conurbation of Glasgow is underlain by mine workings. And if you take a broader view, much of the Midland Valley of Scotland is too. Most of our towns and cities are there because of the presence of coal workings, and the same is the case of many areas in the North, Midlands and South Wales. The potential is clearly there.